Hello my lovelies, this is BL Fanatics and welcome back to my video. Today I'm doing a reaction and recap video of Best Friend the series. I'm planning to do these type of recap videos for all the new series that are airing. I think doing it in this format helps me in conveying my thoughts in a more orderly manner, and it will also look better visually for you guys instead of me just recording the reaction with my phone. So today we are talking about Best Friend the series. The premiere episode aired on 18th February and it's one of the most anticipated series of this year. I was looking forward to watching it really bad for the past 2 years. Everything from the premise to the chemistry of the actors in the trailer seemed right up my alley, and I couldn't wait for the series to air. Now that the first episode has aired, I have some thoughts about it. So let's talk, shall we? Best Friend the series is about two co-workers, Ua and King, who develop a friend with benefits relationship after a drunken one-night stand. First of all, I really like James's look in the series. I loved the fact that his stylist decided to complement his character's personality and dressed him in a more feminine style. I think it's quite refreshing to see, as we are so used to seeing protagonists in BLs always being so heteronormative looking. Now, I'm struggling to find other things I liked about this premiere episode, so let me just dive in and talk about some of the main flaws of this episode. My biggest problem with the show is the pacing. It felt too rushed. There were a lot of things that happened in the first episode, making the whole thing chaotic to watch. Because we don't know the whole background, it just felt like Ua is stuck up and is hating on King for no reason. That made his character a little bit annoying to me. Later on in the episode, it was shown that he doesn't like cheaters, as King approached Ua at the club when he already had a date. But it still wasn't shown why this is such a trigger for him. Because I have skimmed through the novel, I know what the reason is, but people who haven't read it might get confused by his temper tantrums. Not only was Ua cold towards King, but he had a similar attitude towards other characters in the office as well. So is he just really a cold and distant person, or does he only have hatred towards King? That part was quite confusing to me. Another thing I hate about these Domundi dramas are the excessive use of beauty filters. Like, why are you hiding the actor's normal skin tone? It makes the whole show look fake and takes away the realism from the characters. The editing was also off, and it looked like it was a shoddy and rushed job done by the editors, as clips were thrown together haphazardly. We find out that Ua's boyfriend is cheating on him, so he breaks up with his boyfriend. But the next day, he's just living his life normally as if nothing happened. There is no reaction from his side, no afterthoughts of being broken up with his boyfriend. It seemed like the breakup didn't affect him much, which means that his relationship with his ex was not as deep to begin with. So why is his ex so hung up on him and still keeps calling him? To make us understand the depth of their relationship, we needed some scenes of them being together, or if not that, then showing Ua's reaction over their breakup or the ex's reaction could have helped in understanding their relationship better. But again, due to the rushed pacing, we didn't have a clue what's going on in his relationship. I feel like the director should have taken the first episode to establish Ua's character well, instead of shoving one event after another down our throats without any knowledge of the main characters. Now comes the childhood trauma part. I just feel like it was too soon. We don't know who Ua is yet. How are we supposed to feel bad for him? It is again a direction mistake, pushing his trauma on unsuspecting viewers when the viewers still haven't been able to connect to the character made his panic attack scene lose its impact. I didn't feel anything for him when he was having a hard time in the darkness because I just got to know him 5 minutes ago. Now Yim as Jade. I hate to say this, but his acting was not good as Jade. It felt like he carried over his character as Sin from Cutie Pie and did the exact same facial expressions and dialogue delivery for his role as Jade in Best Friend. Jade is an average guy who isn't approached by guys and always fades into the background. But he's not dumb or childish. Yim made his character of Jade look very juvenile, which felt off, and I couldn't help but compare him to Tommy, who would have done this role better justice than Yim, unfortunately. Is it just me that didn't get any sexual tension between King and Ua? It felt like only King is interested in Ua and Ua just has pure hatred for King. Even when they showed flashback of their meeting at the bar, it didn't look like Ua had the least bit of interest in King. So I found it really hard to believe that Ua was sexually attracted to King enough to do a one-night stand with him. Now the NC scene itself was so choreographed and performative that it looked like it was an acrobatic dance performance instead of a sex scene. They touched their lips for 2 seconds and then King parkoured on Ua and the whole thing was finished in 2 seconds. I didn't feel as though both of them were really into the scene. The over-editing and animation took away the feelings aspect of the whole scene. Why were they showing the sex scene like it was a photo shoot and someone was clicking pictures of them in various sensual poses? Like, what the hell was even happening? I'm so confused. You know what? Don't give me any NC scenes. I'm not a sex-hungry maniac who just looks for sex scenes in dramas. I want to see the tension. I want to see how much the two characters want each other. I want to see them craving each other. I don't want a photo shoot of sexual positions with weird camera flashes and horrible editing. I'm sad to say this, but Ned James had better chemistry in Catch Me Baby, where they were just a side couple, than in this one. Now, I liked King's character. Ned's acting is good and he portrayed his character well. I like how King is a flirt but is caring towards Ua and has a clear liking towards him since the beginning. I feel like he's too soft and sweet towards Ua even after Ua's chilly attitude towards him. None of the side characters were established enough for me to remember them, and that's sad because this is giving me flashbacks from shows like Work From Heart, and that's not a good thing for anybody. In my opinion, the show failed to establish a theme in the first episode. In the beginning, we see some light-hearted office environment where everyone is goofy, King is flirty, and Jade is there with his boba tea. But immediately after 10 minutes, we dive into childhood abuse, trauma, and homophobia. There was so much going on that I could not take Ua's past seriously at all. I get that it is just an 8-episode show, so they have to cram a lot of stuff in one episode. But it doesn't help because the viewer is left confused and isn't able to establish focus or connection to any character. Now overall, am I going to keep watching the show? I mean, yes, it was entertaining enough to keep me watching for a few more episodes. But I can't lie, guys, I was massively disappointed with the first episode. It was poorly produced and edited considering the fact that they spent 2 years making the show. The background sound was distracting and overpowering, making it super hard to connect with the characters. I would love to hear your opinion about the first episode of Bed Friend, as I want to know if it's just me who is disappointed with the first episode or there are other people like me. Also, let me know if you are happy with the first episode and liked it, because I want to know what are the points that made you like it, because maybe I'm missing something. As always, if you liked today's video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more BL ranking, news, reviews, and gossip videos. See you all soon. Bye.